Hey everyone, Patrick CK here with the showcase for the Weme hard drive adapter, model MST-003. I chose to showcase this little guy because I thought it was a cool piece of kit for the mobile computer technician or even the average Joe who may still have a IDE based hard drive with important files on it but no compatible hardware anymore. I've also never actually seen an adapter like this before, so I was very curious to see how it works. So I asked Weme if I could check one out, and they shipped one over. In the box, you get the adapter itself, a short Molex power cable for the 3.5-inch IDE drives, a 12-volt wall adapter, a USB 3.0 Type-A data cable, a user pamphlet, and a mini CD-ROM for the OneTouch backup software. More on that in a bit. The adapter itself is deceptively simple looking, but has quite a few features. On one side is the full-size IDE connector for the 3.5-inch hard drives. Next is the smaller IDE connector for the 2.5-inch IDE hard drives. Then we have the SATA connector for either a 3.5-inch or 2.5-inch SATA hard drives. On top is a power LED and a button that operates the OneTouch backup feature. Along the back is the power switch, the 12-volt power input, the USB 3.0 micro B connection, and lastly the power out for the Molex connection. This is used for hooking up a 3.5-inch IDE hard drive. You simply use the provided Molex cable, hooking the smaller connector into the back of the adapter and the large end into the hard drive once it's slotted into the adapter. It creates a very snug fit, which I like. One cool feature about this setup is that you can also connect IDE-based CD and DVD drives into the 3.5-inch slot. One thing to remember if you find yourself needing to hook up a 3.5-inch and 2.5-inch IDE drive at the same time is the jumper selection. If you're not too familiar with the old school IDE hard drives, each drive has a little area, usually next to the data connection, with a jumper that will indicate whether the hard drive is the primary hard drive, also known as the master, or a secondary hard drive, also known as a slave. You just have to make sure that one drive is set to master and the other is set to the slave drive. Most drives of this type will have a diagram or some indication of where the jumper should be positioned for the desired selection. This old Western Digital drive has a diagram right on the label and also a simple legend directly below the jumper area. To move the jumper, delicately remove it with a pair of tweezers and slide it to the desired position. With that in mind, you can have up to 3 drives connected simultaneously, making this adapter quite versatile. Whether you're using a IDE or SATA drive, when you hook them up and power on the adapter, the LED indicator on top turns blue, and anything connected will appear alongside your other drives, ready to use. I wanted to see what kind of performance you can get out of this guy, so I ran a few tests. To best represent some real-world transfers, I created a 1.5GB package with almost 2,000 files that consisted of sizable videos, and a large hierarchy of smaller files like Word docs, spreadsheets, pictures, etc. Running this file back and forth on an old SanDisk SSD slotted in place shows transfer speeds up to 180 megabytes per second, or 1.4 gigabits per second, dropping near the end as it hit all the smaller files. Do not expect this kind of performance from an IDE drive. I saw speeds maxing out at 54 megabytes per second, which is actually surprising considering the IDE standard calls for far slower speeds. The mere fact that you can hook up an IDE drive to your computer without messing around with old ribbon cables is amazing to me. This on its own pays for itself, especially for those who need to pull data from these old drives, even if the computer they were originally attached to have long ago stopped functioning. I love this thing. There is one more feature that adds to this adapter's versatility. That is the OneTouch backup that I think is pretty unique for something so small. It does take some additional software to set up, which can be either installed from the mini CD included or downloaded from Weme at the link below, or directly from the product page also at the link below. To set up the One Touch Backup, or OTB, install the software and follow these instructions. From the main OTB screen, select the drive you want to copy the data to, the target. When the target drive is selected, the backup configuration icon will be enabled. Go ahead and select this icon. Next, check the box labeled Set as Origin PC and select Save. Now select the OTB path icon and choose which files you want to back up. You can choose an entire drive or individual folders from the screen. When you're done making your selections, click Save. Looking at the Options section, the Check OTB Status option should be enabled by default. If not, check this box, and this will ensure the backup function can be run by pressing the button on top of the adapter. You can also request a confirmation before starting a backup by checking the box next to Confirm for Backup. This can help avoid any accidental backup requests. With this super easy setup, you can start backing up your most important files in less than 3 minutes. And once everything's set up, all you have to do is tap the button on top of the adapter and let it do its thing. To restore data, select the Restore icon on the OTB main screen and follow these instructions. You can either choose to restore back to the original file that the data came from, or choose a custom location to restore to. Then all you have to do is click the Restore button to begin the process. That wraps up my showcase of the Weme hard drive adapter. It is a great little companion for anyone that needs to hook up older IDE drives without having to worry about compatible hardware or ribbon cables, or someone just looking to pull archives without having to take their computer apart. And for 20 bucks, you can't go wrong. As a special offer to my viewers, you can get an additional 10% off when buying the adapter on Amazon. Discount code and link will be in the description. This has been Patrick CK. Like and share if you enjoyed this content. Consider subscribing to get more videos when they come out. Hope to see you all next time. So long for now.